Hollyland has recently released a new set of radio mics, the Lark Max. I've been using the Lark 150 for a number of years since they came out, but I've been using the new Lark Max for a number of weeks now, and the quality of the sound is so much better. And not only that, but it has so many improvements, not just over the Lark 150, but over what Rode or DJI offer. And the first noticeable difference is the battery life, because you can now record an amazing 7.5 hours on the transmitter and 9.5 hours on the receiver on a single battery use. And you get a battery case that allows you to record up to 3 times from fully discharged to full charge. That means that you have over 24 hours of battery life, which in practical terms means you are never gonna run out of battery. Not only that, but you can now record both externally onto a camera and also internally. And that's great because you can now record up to 14 hours of 24-bit uncompressed WAV directly onto the transmitter itself at 48 kilohertz sample rate. And all of that, you can do that either by pressing record on the transmitter itself or also on the receiver. And this is great if you do narrative or interviews or similar environments where it's not really practical to be walking up the talent and trigger the record on off button or asking them to do it. You can now trigger wirelessly the recording from the receiver itself, and that's gonna save you a ton of time and hassle. And it goes without saying that you can be recording both internally onto the transmitter and externally onto a camera via the receiver, both simultaneously. And you have a safety lock on the receiver itself, so you don't accidentally press a button and mess up with the recording. You also get 3 recording modes. You get stereo, mono, and safety track, which I think is fantastic, especially if you're in a situation where you have a lot of loud background noise, or you might be recording someone that has very high tones. You can now have a normal recording and a safety track at -6 dB. And that's gonna give you a lot of flexibility, because what that means is that even if the person picks at any point, you always have a safe track to use. One of the really cool things that the Lark Max offers is the fact that you have a built-in noise cancellation filter as well as a low cut filter that you can turn on and off as you please. Now, as you can clearly see, I'm in a place where it's far from ideal for recording sound, which is inches away from a very busy road. But let me show you what a big difference these filters do when I turn them on, and I'm gonna start with the noise cancellation. And you can now listen to the quality of the sound when I turn on the noise cancellation. And even more, let me show you what happens when I turn on the low cut filter. And this is the quality of the sound that you get with both noise cancellation and low cut filters on. And I think it does a really good job. On top of that, Hollyland has these lavalier microphones that are really good. They're actually really good value for money. They are a little bit bigger than the high-end lavalier microphones, but you are paying 10 or 20 times less. So I think they do a really good job. And look, I have a helicopter hovering over my head. I got lorries, trucks, taxis, buses. This is a very loud environment. I would not normally be recording sound in a place like this. But hopefully this illustrates how good this combo is. Personally, I don't use any of these filters unless I genuinely need it. So for instance, in most of my filming, I don't use any of them and I do everything in post. This would be one of the very few situations where I would use the noise cancellation as well as the low cut filter. And it's, if I was to be doing anything that I'm publishing direct to social media and I need my audio to sound good and I am right next to a very busy road as I am now. As you can clearly see, I got traffic. It's a very busy road, but this is a very nice side. You know, it's a very nice bridge. You would never imagine that there is such a busy road just literally inches away from me. So this would be a very good situation when to use both these filters, because you're gonna get rid of all this crazy background sound that I don't even know if you can hear any of it, but it's really, really loud. If there is one area where the Lark Max improves significantly over the Lark 150, it's on the signal range, because you now have a 250 meter or around 820 feet within direct line of sight, and that's gonna give you a lot of flexibility. Now, I'm not just gonna walk away for 250 meters to show you that there is no signal loss, because that's a bit of an unrealistic example, because most people that use wireless radio mics, they use them for vlogging, for filming interviews, for filming themselves, for narrative short films, and usually you are within a few feet from your camera, at most a room or 2 rooms away. So instead, I'm gonna show you how these wireless microphones perform as I walk through rooms, doors, and even floors. So let's turn this thing on. I can hear it, you can hear it, Let's go for a walk. Okay, so this is where the signal dropped out. And I think this is amazing for most people. It's two floors, several rooms, thick walls, a main door. This is more than enough for most people.
And this is fantastic because what this system gives you is the peace of mind that you can rely on the wireless transmission. And on top of that, if you find yourself in a situation that you cannot afford any signal loss, you just record internally into the transmitter and you're done. And another area where I think there is a big improvement over the Lark 150 is on the mounting options, because you still have your hot shoe mount, but you now have a magnetic mount. And this is fantastic if, for instance, you're using action cameras, so any type of camera that doesn't have cold shoe mount, and you can just attach it to the camera and you are done. And I've tested this with the DJI Action 4 and it works fantastic.
So you see here, it's okay. But the moment we start pedaling, this is pretty much unusable. I would not want to be using this kind of audio. We now have the Hollyland on, noise reduction on. And you can clearly hear the difference. As I pedal, you cannot hear any of that wind noise that you had before. This is a really big difference.
But if there is one area where the Lark Max improves significantly over the Lark 150, it's on the operation of the receiver. Because you now have a really nice little LCD screen that is also a touch screen, as well as a jog dial. And that combination is really nice. The browsing of the menu, the adjustments and the settings are really easy to get to. They're really easy to adjust. And the whole experience is really nice. And I genuinely like the jog wheel on the side that allows you to easily adjust the volume up and down, because sometimes on location, once you are recording, it's really difficult to be swiping and be touching an LCD screen, whereas you can now easily dial up and down. It's really nice and intuitive. I think this is a massive improvement over the Lark 150 by a long stretch. And it goes without saying that you can record audio directly via the transmitter itself, because it's a microphone on its own, or using a lavalier mic via the 3.5 mm input jack, which gives you all the options that you need. And you could just literally use the transmitter as a field recorder without the receiver, because you might be in a situation that you just want to record sound and then sync it in post, and you don't want to be connecting the receiver to the camera and dealing with wires. So you get both options. You can record directly into the camera or into the microphone itself. And the price itself for what you get compared to what DJI or Rode is offering, I think it's fantastic value for money. And these are the wireless microphones that I've been using for the last couple of months, and I haven't had a single problem. So, would I recommend them? Absolutely. And I'm not just telling you this because I leave a link in the video description below. It's because I genuinely believe that if you invest in these wireless microphones, they're gonna last you for years and they're gonna give you incredible quality. And I genuinely hope that you enjoyed this video, that you found it helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.